yesterday, ahead of the Tuesday mandamano that was scheduled, the president came and addressed the nation, telling people that the protests were being funded by a company known as Ford Foundation. And he actually swore that he will make sure that does not happen, and emphasize that either the company leaves the country or it abides with the democratic principles of Kenya. And today the company has come out and denied the allegations of the president, and it has actually given it history. It has explained what it has done and its role in civic responsibility or civic duty. And it seems like the company or the organization is totally rejecting any comments that came from the president alleging that they were involved in the protest. So in this video, I want us to assess the comments that came from the president and look it together or compare with what Ford Foundation said, and also look at the reality to see who is really being the truthful person or who is lying to us. So if you are new to our channel, please take a moment and subscribe so that we can continue creating a bigger family of the Socrato TV. Remember, at the Socrato TV, we explore, discuss, and discover the hidden stories shaping our political landscape. Now, the protests that has been happening in Kenya are very new type of protest that has never been witnessed before. And one of the strange things about them, or unique, is that they are not being led by any specific individual, in the sense that even after arresting one person, a few days later, the protests still go on like it's no one's business. So I think that has really made it very difficult for the government even to identify any particular person to arrest and say this is the leader. And the Gen Zs themselves have also used that strategy to ensure that their movement lasts longer. They have ridiculed and fought any individual who wanted or who may have wished to proclaim themselves as their leader. And the government has tried using very different mechanism to try and ensure that it suppresses or ends this protest. Among the strategies they used, we had even deployment of KDF. At some point, there are goons who infiltrated the protest, and largely these goons are believed to have been brought by government sympathizers to ensure that the protests are painted as violent. We have also seen other strategies, including even calling for Raila Amolo Odinga for dialogue, which terribly failed. You have seen this strategy of dissolving cabinet, and even IG of police resigning, but all seem not to be working. So I think the president has decided now to create a perception or create a picture that these protests are not organic, and they are only but artificially being fueled by a specific group of people or specific individual. And that's why he brought in Ford Foundation. And I think I understand that the president, by bringing in Ford Foundation, he wanted also to show the international or the globe that what is happening in Kenya is bigger than maybe what people are crying about, so that there's influence from an international camp, big organization. And what I find very interesting is that the very organization he's complaining about found its basis or its origins from the United States of America. And we have seen that there has been this kind of happiness or bromance between the United States of America and Kenya, especially in his tenure as the president. So I don't understand where he's coming to blame this company. Assuming he was blaming a company from Russia or China, I will have easily got into idea that is now showing that there is a geopolitical fight. But by bringing this foundation, it does not even make a lot of sense, because there is some relationship between this company and Kenya. And in fact, when he visited United States of America, he sat together with the chairman or the person who leads this organization. So it is difficult to really understand what he's trying to do, apart from just knowing that he's creating just that perception that this movement is not organic. And by sacrificing that kind of organization may mean that maybe it is possible this company may have in some way involved in educating the society. You know, the company is based on giving people the civic education about good governance, how democracy works, importance of going to the streets, such things. So I think the idea is just that they have seen this company is playing a huge role in educating the masses. And I link this with the fact that the same regime has been also taking, or it has also been abducting, not arresting, abducting people who offer some civic education or who try to educate people about matters to do with good governance and politics. So it will have been very difficult to attack that company directly on the basis of it giving civic education. It will also have been difficult to attack that company or to maybe abduct somebody there. So the only best strategy they identified and so worth to use is to say it is giving money to people and motivating them to protest. Now, by the company coming out and saying the claims are untrue and they are not justified, of course, it also taints or stains the image of the government and makes them look like liars. Of course, their responsibility, they have also outlined the fact that they give civic education. They have not shied away to say maybe their role in this protest, which will have been just to educate people, of course, which is okay. And the fact that they have identified that which is their role, which I believe is the reason why the government is attacking them, I think we can now look or connect with what Mwananchi is going through. Is Mwananchi justified, or are people justified? Do they have something to bite on the basis of their protest? And I will start by looking at what the president did, the actions or the things that he has been doing in response to the protest. He withdrew the finance bill. If the Ford Foundation was financing this protest, was there any reason to withdraw the finance bill or just cut off or expel this Ford Foundation? I think it would have been easier to expel the Ford Foundation because he had the powers and let the finance bill go on. Secondly, he dissolved the cabinet. Will it have been easier to dissolve your whole cabinet of 21 cabinet ministers or just chase away people who want to infiltrate your ruling or your country? I think it had been easier actually to deal with these people. So that also shows that the president did not say the truth. Another thing is, at the point of saying this, what did the president want to achieve? What did he want to achieve? For me, the day before, which is now today, was a protesting day where people were to protest and to water down maybe the international media from covering it and maybe even some people from going to protest. So it was just to show that there are some individuals who are gaining or who are profiting or who are getting money from this protest, but we are very few in the ground, those now who go to the street, who are suffering, but they are gaining nothing. So it was to demotivate these who are going to to make them know that they are being used by some elements at the top just to profit. And all these narratives, I think they can be justified to some degree. But the big issue or the elephant in the room is that there is the issues that people are raising are very simple. They are raising accountability, they are raising constitutionalism, and they also want government that is based on competence. It would have been very shameful of the protesters if maybe the education sector was doing well, health sector was doing well, or all other sectors, then they still go to the street. As much as there could be some opportunistic elements who may take advantage of the situation to try and infiltrate the protest, but that can only happen if there is a loophole. And that loophole can only be created by some kind of ineptness. So whether there is infiltration, whether there is a company that is doing whatever it's doing, I think the bigger picture is solving or dealing with the core issues that are affecting these people who are going to protest. Bringing in accountability, bringing in people who are competent, and also ensuring that the constitution is followed to the letter. So any person who will try to infiltrate people who are already enjoying how their country is being run will be exposed and will not be able to really succeed. And I think that is the best strategy that can be done to ensure that the country is on the right direction. I don't know what you think about this. Please feel free to share your opinion at the comment box so that we can continue with this kind of conversation. Remember, at the Socrato TV, we emphasize that you need to stay curious, stay thoughtful, and stay critical. Until we meet again,